Yes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Amadou. I'm doing a short video or a eulogy about Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad, the Emir of Kuwait, who passed away on the 29th of September. This is Sabah Al-Ahmad Masjid and Islamic Education Center. This masjid was named after him in recognition of his tremendous contribution for its construction. Inshallah, I would like to ask, Assalamu alaikum, brother. This is brother Ismail, Eski. Brother, you know, this masjid is named after our respected Emir, who has passed on, Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad. Today is Friday, 2nd of October, 2020. Do you have anything to say?
May Allah accept his good deed and forgive him and grant him to paradise, inshallah.
Inshallah, ameen. Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much. Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is, what's your name, brother? And do you have any message for the passing on of our elder and leader who is named after our masjid here, Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Hassan Isa Saeed. May Allah grant him a Jannah, Amir Sabah Al-Ahmad. May Allah, inshallah, grant him Jannah al-Firdaus for what he did for good deed. And too many people witnessed for him. He did good deed, and may Allah, inshallah, accept that good deed. And may Allah, inshallah, you know, the following Amir, he's continuing his legacy. And we are witness here. We help the Canberrian community and Canberrian Muslim community in the south to build this masjid. And may Allah, inshallah, will be from Hasanat, because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Qatar, Amal ibn Adam illa min salas. Sadaqatun jariya. Aw amalun salih intafa'u bihin nas. This is amal salih intafa'u bihin nas. Aw ibnun. ابن صالح يدعو له او عمل
righteous child
عمل ينتفع به الناس
ان شاء الله
this is عمل ان شاء الله will ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept it in his حسنات
امين
جزاكم الله خير فوق
السلام عليكم برادر ايماد
السلام ورحمة الله
how are you okay yes this masjid is named after the respected Emir of Kuwait who has passed on Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad on the 29th of September today is the 2nd of October Do you have any message for the Muslim community in Canberra or around the world?
Well, subhanAllah, the Emir of Kuwait was a great Muslim leader.
Alhamdulillah.
He was a person that he will be pining to do the good righteous deeds. He made the Kuwait leaped as a hub country in the region. He was a mediator between all the Middle Eastern countries when there is a dispute.
Is that why they call him the Dean of Peace, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Not just because of his age or his seniority, but he was a wise man. It's a generation that really rooted into the good grounds that it was feeding good to the others. We never seen him obnoxious, we never seen him showing off. He was a very humble person despite of his distinguished position. And that's a lesson about, as the Imam mentioned, about a legacy that he's leaving behind him.
That
I hope that the new generation will take a leaf from his book. I hope the new generation will keep that baton and will learn how to be humble and how to be deeply rooted in their Islam, in their Aruba, like their Amir. May Allah accept him.
Amen.
May Allah grant him the highest place in paradise.
Amen. And the amazing thing about this Emir, you don't hear, when his name is mentioned, you don't hear politics. You hear a good human. It's amazing.
Absolutely.
Not many leaders are like that.
Absolutely.
Subhanallah.
That's the soft leadership.
Alhamdulillah.
That's what our leaders should learn. To be humble and to be deeply grounded to do the good things. That's the true spirit of Islam.
He was a wise man, wallahi. That is so true. Jazakallah khair, brother. This is Brother Ashrof, the principal of the Sunday school that is established here in the Sabah Al-Ahmad Masjid and Islamic Education Center. Our masjid is named after a respectable elder and leader, and he's passed on. Do you have anything to say?
Oh, yes, I mean, we are sad about the demise of the Emir of Kuwait, because I mean, he planted the seeds for future alims and imams and for all learned people coming from the Muslim Ummah in Australia. And without his support and without the beneficiary of the people of Kuwait and the government of Kuwait, this may have not been possible. But of course, you know, Allah knows best. But we are so sorry that we lose the Emir of Kuwait, and we hope that Allah grants him Jannatul Firdaus.
Amen.
And he gives his family sabr,
Amen.
And the people of Kuwait also sabr,
Amen.
And may give them more resources so that they can do more projects like this,
Amen.
And have more in education.
Inshallah.
So, Jazakumullah khairan. Thank you very much to the people of Kuwait and to the government of Kuwait for helping us bring the level of education a bit higher in the students of Canberra and, of course, Australia.
Jazakallah khairan. What do you have to say?
I think it's a massive contribution that he has made to a lot of people and all that, and the way he has already contributed and worked for a better of the humanity and all that, and our masjid is only a small part of it and all, and we are very grateful for that, and may Allah give the Amir the Jannah he deserves.
Amen.
And
Allah.
May Allah certainly forgive all his sins.
Amen.
And as I said, give him his reward that he deserves so much.
Amen.
And it was a massive support that we got for our masjid, and we are ever grateful. And not only that, as Imam just mentioned, that he not only did this is very small contribution for him, but he did a lot of big stuff and all that, and may Allah bring more people like him to this world so that they can do good for the humanity.
Amen.
And may Allah reward him for his best deeds and all that.
Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much. Thanks. Brother Shamsul.
Alaykum
salam wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. This is Imam Adama Konda.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullah.
The Imam of Sabah Al-Ahmad Masjid and Islamic Education Center here in Canberra. Alhamdulillah, Imam. Jazakallah khair for the khutbah and for the remembrance of all our fallen Muslim brothers and sisters. You also mentioned the Emir of Kuwait, the late Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad. And do you have anything to add to your khutbah? You already said everything.
Alhamdulillah, I mean, I cannot say everything because Allah knows this man more than us.
Yeah.
And that's why he chose him for what he has done. You know, some people are chosen. Many people have position like his, you know, but the way they use their position is different. So, but when you are gifted, you know, you will realize that it is very important to be in the right place, in the right time. But what is more important is to do the right thing while you are there. And to me, to my short knowledge, I believe this man did. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him fully. And he left a big challenge to the whole world. And that challenge is that, can we carry and move on with the legacy he left? I mean, our condolence to the people of Kuwait, that they lost someone who they loved and we loved. But we need to fulfill his will. And his will is that his legacy should continue.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to live up to this title. And when life ends, legacy begins. And many people are spoken about mostly after they die. That when the whole world would witness and say their testimony about that person. So it is really a mourning time.
Mm-hmm.
But for this type of this man, we don't celebrate death. We celebrate life, because he is alive, regarding to his achievement. Because we live after we are gone with what we left behind. And I know it is a big challenge. Our condolence, not to the people of Kuwait, only to all of us. Because he was a flag of peace all over the world. Politicians witnessed, religious people witnessed, and the common people witnessed. And I believe he touched every ethnic, every culture, every home. And that is good enough here. But as I always say, Allah told us not to praise one another. Wala tuzaku anfusakum huwa alam bimani taqon. You know, Allah knows really who the man is and who he was. And but as far as we witness as human beings, hearing about him and seeing the achievement, the smiling face, he lived beyond grave. Because his good deeds is what will keep him alive.
Sure.
So our condolence to the people of Kuwait, and reminding to live up to the challenge that he left. Sure. And that challenge is that, will Kuwait give birth to someone who will carry his legacy? And we believe yes, inshallah.
Sure.
And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us part of his legacy.
Amen.
Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.
Amen. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As a continuation, I have here in the Sabah Al-Ahmad Masjid, the president of the executive committee of the Canberra Islamic Center, Brother Suhail Khan. He wants to say a short word with regards to the death of our respected elder and emir, Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad. Assalamu alaikum, Brother Suhail.
Assalamu alaikum, Brother Amdu. How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
Brother, we were very saddened by the death of the Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmad. And, of course, we were following his admission to the hospital and Mashallah, he lived to a ripe old age, and we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send such a kind and noble person on this earth who did a lot of humanitarian work, not only for us, but all around the world, which was recognized by the United Nations as one of the most humanitarian person with his the wealth bestowed on him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used it for the good of the poor and of the people who were in need. So, Alhamdulillah, all of us have to go back. As you know, we come from Allah and we go back to Allah. May Allah give him the highest place in Jannatul Firdaus. And what I want to say about the history of this beautiful masjid, as you can see. Yeah. And this is the most modern and most beautiful masjid. Yeah. It is was only possible with the help of the Amir. And we are eternally grateful to the state of Kuwait and to the Amir, to the late Amir himself, that this building and this masjid and Sabah Al-Ahmad Educational Center came into existence. Although we had been trying to collect money from our sources, and we did collect a fair bit of money, but there is a small community here, and it is hard to collect so much of money which we needed for this masjid. Ambassador Khalid Al-Shabani, who used to pray in the CIC hall along with us when he was the ambassador here, was the instigator. He took me aside and said, make a submission and I will forward it to the right people in Kuwait, which he did. And because of his efforts, we were able to get our submission to the Amir himself, and it was sanctioned. And then, of course, he was transferred from here, and we got an angel of an ambassador, Najib al-Badr. His Excellency Najib al-Badr became a friend of CIC, and he was actively involved in the building of this project. Since he has gone, the masjid has been inaugurated. In his presence, it was inaugurated, and it's going from strength to strength. We get good support from the Kuwaiti embassy, the present ambassador and his staff, the ambassador, Mr. Montar Al-Isa. He has been supportive of what we are doing here. And Alhamdulillah, this place is buzzing with people. We have three jamaats for Jummah because there are so many people and there are some restrictions because of the virus. We maintain that. And inshallah, the late Amir will get the Sadqa-e Jariya, which is accrued to him because of his efforts and because of his generous donation. So we are eternally grateful to the state of Kuwait and to the Amir, and may Allah bless him, and may Allah give him the highest place in Jannat al-Firdaus.
Mm-hmm.
And we wish the new Amir, the Crown Prince, who will be proclaimed as the Amir, inshallah, with all the best.
Mm-hmm.
And may he be as kind and gentle and with his humanitarian efforts, and we hope to pray for his success, and we hope that we get the same support. I have no doubt about that. We will continue to get that support, because this masjid and the education center on my left there carries the name of Kuwait and carries the late Amir's name as Sabah Al-Ahmad Masjid. So that's all I've got to say, and thank you very much.
Okay.
Jazakallah khair.
Yes.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.